Welcome to the art room with Mr. Cummings. I am excited to work with each and every one of you as we explore different art styles and movements, working with different materials and learning about artists.
Hi kids, there's a shadow. I'm sitting here with my daddy. You know him as Mr. Cummings, and he and I are going to take you through some of the stuff we're going to do this year in art class. It's going to be really fun. So be really good and draw some really special stuff. Okay. Oh, and I give daddy a kiss. Okay. Take it away.
We will be focusing on learning about the different elements of art, which include line, shape, color, value, form, texture, and space. We will have the experiences of working with different art materials, such as painting, drawing, sculpture, textiles and fabric, collage, and photography. We will be studying art from other cultures such as Native America, Mexico, Australia, Egypt, and Japan. We will be learning about different art styles and movements such as realism, cubism, expressionism, pop art, surrealism, impressionism, pointillism, and op art. Let's take a few moments to go over the art room rules that I post in the classroom. Rule number one is the most important of all. That is, listen quietly and work quietly. When I am speaking, it usually means that I'm going over something very important that you're going to need to pay attention to. If I have a lot of people talking at the same time, or even one or two people talking, it gets very distracting. And when we're working, I don't mind some quiet chatting while you're doing your work. Otherwise, please keep the noise to a minimum. Rule number two, raise your hand for questions. That's also very important. It becomes kind of chaotic and crazy if people are just yelling out comments without raising their hand. So if you have something to say, wait for the appropriate time and then raise your hand and I will call on you. Rule number three, let's put our time to good use and not waste it. When it comes time to work, work as hard as you can, do your 100% during our project time. Rule number four, please don't yell out comments when I am going over something or speaking. Just because I take a breath or I pause for a minute doesn't mean that you need to chime in and add your two cents when it's not necessary. So please keep comments to a minimum. Also, no loud banging on the table with your hands or shaking your chair, so that creates sounds too. Rule number five, respect yourself and your classmates. This is very important. You are to respect everybody that's in the room. That goes for teachers, aides, and your fellow classmates. Use kind words. Don't be belittling anybody or putting anybody down. And don't be acting disrespectfully towards adults. And finally, rule number six, clean up after yourself. That means that when it's the final 5 minutes of our class and I do the cleanup clap, people are going to be picked as volunteers to help go around the room to clean up supplies and put things away where they properly belong. If you have any garbage around you, please dispose of it. The cleanup clap goes like this. Come on, dance with me. Funky Town, won't you take me to
funky town. Go, Shadow, go. You're the disco king.
Oh, Daddy, I like this town.
Ooh, me too. Here is a list of the consequences if you choose to not follow the rules or if you choose to misbehave. Number one, you could be seated away from your classmates for a period of time until you calm down. Number two, I might give you written work rather than art projects to do. I have a lot of written assignments in my desk that I could give you. Number three, I really don't want to have to, but I will do this. I will have to contact your parents through making a call after school or sending an email. And number four, you definitely don't want to be sent to the principal's office, because then that will be a sign that your parents are going to be notified also.
Do you really want to walk out of art looking like this?
And now here's a list of all the good things that can happen if you choose to work nicely in the art room and you are respectful of other people around you. Number one, when people finish their art projects, I will pick some of the really successful ones and hang them up in the hallway. So I love to have the hallway filled with art projects that are displayed. Number two, you could be selected as a volunteer to help out or clean up or maybe go to the office and be a messenger. Number three, the art award will be given to one person at the end of class, and they will be able to bring that home to show their parents how well they did in art that day. And number four, the class with the most tens will get some type of reward. It used to be a popcorn party before COVID. I'm not sure what the reward will be, but I do this two times a year, once at the end of December and once at the end of June. So you will have two chances for your class to earn the most tens out of any other class in the school.
Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
I talk too, Daddy.
And this is our award note. The award note is given to a particular student at the end of each art class who I thought really worked hard, followed directions, and gave their 100% best effort. So what I would do is I would take a blank award note and I would fill it out, put the student's name and draw a funny face, and then hand it to them. And then you could take it home and show your family or hang it up on the refrigerator and feel proud that you did a great job today in art. In the art room, there will be a series of faces that will be hanging up. I keep them in a pouch and they're used to keep track of behavior. So if this face happens to be posted on the whiteboard, it means that I'm seeing a little bit of the beginnings of some behaviors that I'm not too crazy about. And I'm hoping that when I hang this face, the behavior or behaviors won't continue. If this face is hung up next to the one that I just showed you, it probably means that the class is going to end up getting only a 7 or an 8 out of 10 rather than a perfect score, because it means that the behaviors are continuing. If this face gets hung up, then that means that we're not really having a great day. New behaviors are starting to pop up. People aren't listening or they're being disruptive, and the score is going to only be about a 5. And we never, ever, 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 ever want to see this face hanging up on the board. This means that your teacher is probably going to come to pick you up, and they're going to see that all the students have their heads down, hands folded, our class has ended early, the lights are off, because we had to end early because of disruptive behaviors. Your score could be a 3 or less.
Shadow.
I'm shaking my head, Daddy.
I know.
Me too.
This is Mr. Brush, and he is hoping that everybody in this classroom is going to treat him well and with respect and take good care of him.
Hi guys, it's Mr. Brush. Sometimes I have had some really bad experiences, like when somebody tries to wash me and put me away like this. Ooh, ooh, ooh. It's always so much nicer when somebody runs both fingers through the bristles and really gets all the paint out so I'm nice and clean. And then after they turn the water off, please place me in the brush holder facing up like this. I'll be a little bit less claustrophobic. And now, a little tip about helping me sponge desks. There were no sponges at school, so I'm doing this from home. Please don't let me see anybody do this, where we wet the sponge and then bring it over to the table, and then I see this.
Oh, look at me. I'm helping with the sponging. Aren't I doing a good job? How am I doing, Mr. Cummings?
Really?
Oh. Daddy. Really?
Instead, this is how it's done. You run the water. You wet the sponge. You squeeze it as hard as you can over the sink, preferably with two hands, but I'm holding the camera with my one hand. And then you get a nice, even coat. Isn't that lovely?
And now it's time to go over our fire drill procedures.
If the fire drill bell happens to ring during our class, my job is to shut the door and lock it, and then turn out the lights. And then your job as a class is to line up carefully at the door. First person can open the door. And then you will go outside and be directed to where your teacher is telling you to go. There is absolutely no talking during a fire drill or running.
And now let's discuss our school lockdown procedures, where we have to pretend that if there happens to be an unwanted person or intruder in our building, we have to make it appear like every single classroom is emptied out and there's no one in the building.
If there is an announcement made that a lockdown is in the process of happening, either an external or an internal lockdown, my job, once again, is to close and lock the door and make sure that it's shut. So I would close the door. I would turn out the lights once again. Your job as a class is to stand in the area that the door is on that I just locked, which means the class would stand in this corner in the Raritan Valley Art Room. You would stand close together. There is absolutely no noise or sounds or talking during a lockdown drill.
I hope you enjoyed our little introductory video on the art room. Here's to a fun, productive year in art. I want you to be as creative as possible.
Shadow says goodbye.
Kids, this was really fun. It's really nice to meet you by video. And, you know, I wasn't really coerced into doing this. I wanted to say hi, but have a great school year and do lots of art. And Daddy, where's my treat?
Ooh. It's right here.
Chomp, chomp, chomp.
Bye.
Bye, everyone. Happy art.